What's up, my favorite people, my shining stars? I'm hoping you are shining bright, not letting anyone dim that light. My name is Trinity, and welcome to my channel, all about the healing. Thank you for Mariah and Daz. It's been rocking with me from the beginning of my time. Hit that bell button, guys. Hit that bell button. I want you guys to hit that bell button. But furthermore, I want to thank my people for rocking with me from the beginning of this time, for my time. It's been a while, and you guys have been rocking with me. We've been through it. I've been through it. And you have guys have never let me down. You've always kept me holding it down. So I'm just happy that you are still here, still watching, still supporting the channel. Thank you for the donations, for those who donated. Thank you for those that want to donate. Hit the description box. All of that information is in there. For my new subscribers, I want to say thank you and welcome, and I'm honored. For those of you that's here for the first time, I want to say thank you and welcome. So I'm going to ask that you guys hit the description box. Because I'm not going to go through my normal spiel that I normally go through. I'm not going to do that. So hit the description box. All of my information is there. Hold on a second, guys. Let me fix this. All right. Okay. Sorry about that. That my computer kept making that noise. All right. So for those of you, hit that description box. If you have any questions or concerns or anything like that, just email me. I will return your email, okay? I'm just for a few things. I'm not doing any personal readings right now. All of my readings are general readings. They're not going to resonate with everybody. They could go vice versa. Fit it where it go in, guys. I just got an email. So many distractions. So guys, you might be distracted because right now I'm just distracted. So many things popping up and going on. I'm trying to do this. Okay. No personal readings, general readings. And what was the last thing? Oh, guys, please. Use your discernment, intuition, all of that, okay, for these readings, okay, because I don't want to misguide anyone, mislead anybody, but spirit always knows and always keeps it real and 100 with you to let you know if this reading is really your reading, whether it resonates or not. So that's what I'm asking, okay? All right, so if I'm vibing with you, and you vibing with me, and that energy is popping, then go ahead on subscribe. You ain't got to go into the reading. Energy is energy, right? All right. Let me get the roll on. We rolling. And we are honoring the sign of Capricorn. Bam. There it is, Cap. Cap, Cap, Cap. If nobody told you today, Cap, that they love you, let me tell you, I love you. I love you, Cap, okay? If nobody told you that you're awesome, if nobody told you that you the bomb diggity, you the bomb diggity. And that is it. And bam. All right? There it is. And bam. Okay. We're going to be channeling today. Who is spying on you, okay? How is these people spying on you? And why they spying on you, okay? Why they just can't come out and keep it real and tell you how they feel, what's going on, but they got to spy, they got to go through all these changes and asking your friends and running you down and flipping you down, fake accounts and all. Why they just can't tell you? But we're going to find out. We're going to find out what's going on with that. We got initials, we got love, truth, or spirit messages, whichever one comes out, and then we have the oracle. Okay, let's get it in. All right, so your overall energy. Let me get out of here. Okay, so your overall energy for who is spying is the Tower. Now, first of all, the Tower. Okay, this is somebody that you broke up with. This is somebody that you ended something with. This is somebody that you're no longer talking to. This is somebody that spirit intervened in, because the reason why you guys are not together, or the reason why things happen like this, is because spirit intervened, because that's what the Tower moment, the Tower is. Spirit is the one to bring down the Tower. Because what you have built with this person, whether it's a friend, whether it's a lover, whether it's a family member, whatever relationship it is not built on a solid foundation. Something is not right. Somebody's not being real. Somebody's not being authentic. Somebody's lying. Somebody's wearing a mask. Somebody's cheating. Somebody is doing something in this connection that's not right. Okay? And so spirit knows all and sees all. And spirit corrects it by letting a light shine on that situation. Meaning maybe secrets revealed. Maybe somebody get enlightened, you know, and get wisdom that, and see things the way they truly are. Maybe somebody's mask drops and then somebody can see somebody through their mask that they're wearing. Whatever it is, you know your situation. The Tower came down. Spirit brought the Tower down. And when spirit brought the Tower down, it was abrupt. It was sudden. It was shocking. It was paralyzing. When spirit brought this Tower down, it was hurtful. It was very, very painful. However, if you see in this card, you see these butterflies symbolizing transformation. So the Tower came down. And it was painful, but it was meant for you to start over, transform, and renew oneself. Because if it's a connection, you only can heal oneself, yourself. And then if that person does the same, then it'll come together and build that foundation that's correct and go from there. Build that Tower back up. But that's who's spying. Someone you had an ending with. Something. It was a deep connection. It was if spirit brought the Tower down, this was a deep connection. Okay, it was deep. Okay, but when I clarified the Tower, I got the girl with the snake. The girl with the snake is the empath and narcissist paradigm. I had just talked about this in the Cancer reading. And here it is in black and white. All right? Being charmed or used, enabling. Somebody maybe was enabling somebody. Okay? Boundaries. Somebody set boundaries, and the boundaries were, somebody went over these boundaries, did not see, because narcissists, you set boundaries for narcissists, they don't feel like it's like, who are you to set a boundary? They go right over, they disregard boundaries. Who are you to set a boundary? No, that's not how this getting ready to go. And so they flip the script. That's what narcissists do. So, we got an empath and a narcissist paradigm here. And spirit intervened And 9 times out of 10, what I'm feeling from this is that this, the reason why spirit brought this tower is because you didn't really know that this person was a narcissist. You didn't know. They were wearing a mask. This person was wearing a mask and you didn't know that they was a narcissist. And they were manipulating you behind the scenes to get you to do whatever they would get you to be and do what they wanted you to be and do. They were manipulating the manipulating the relationship and the connection. And spirit intervened because you couldn't see. They were wearing a mask. And I before I even went to this card, I told you that somebody was wearing a mask. And spirit revealed through this tower, allowed you to enlighten you to see through this person's mask. And you saw that they were a narcissist. You saw what this person was doing, manipulating you and making and trying to manipulate the relationship and situations to do what you wanted to do what you wanted them to do. This person was using you, and spirit allowed you to see that. That's one scenario. Another scenario is that the tower came down because somebody wasn't. Somebody was a narcissist. Some other people were not. Spirit brought it in because the truth, some secrets was coming out. This was person was wearing a mask, but somebody else had secrets. They will have secrets, and secrets were revealed, and it ended the tower came down. It's all kind of reasons why this tower came down, but you know why. The ultimate, the thing that's coming from this, you know why the tower came down, because you was enlightened. Spirit allowed you to see the truth and revealed the truth to you, and so you could understand what really was going on in your connection, because you was not seeing it clearly. All right, so that is, let's go to how are they spying? How are they spying? Because this person is spying on you because things ended. And it ended abruptly. And this person is lost. This is a narcissist. A narcissist feeds off an empath, their energy. And if you're and this person is not together, and spirit has severed this tie. This person is lost without you. They can't feed off of your energy. They can't feed off of you. This person is lost. This person is spying. This person is probably stalking, but we're going to find out if it's got to stalking. But this person is spying, definitely spying on you. This person is lost without you. This person is trying to get back to you because they want to get back to manipulating you for whatever it is that they need, for their needs. Because this person was manipulating you for what they need, for you to fill their needs. What they needed. Oh my goodness. All right. How this person is stalking you, okay? They pass spying. They riding by your job. Okay, it says riding by your job. Okay. This person is paying tarot readers, spying on you that way. They're trying to find out who you seeing, what you doing behind the scenes. They're trying to figure this thing out. This person is trying to get you back. All social media, they spying on all your social media, okay? They asking friends and family about you, info about you. And they are paying for background checks. To get info. So they doing background checks, paying tarot readings for you to get information, asking family and friends to get information, riding by your job. Okay, so this person is trying to get back to you because they're lost without your energy. They're empath needs, they're low. An empath are low vibrational, very low vibrational. They feed off of other people's energy so they can survive. because they do not want to do the work that's required for them to stand on their own 2 feet and be able to move forward in life on their own. They refuse to face. They have so much pride and ego that they refuse to face their, they have fears of facing that. Facing things that happened in the past, or facing things that they did wrong. They don't, these type of people, they don't apologize. They can't apologize because they can't be wrong. They're never wrong. Oh no, they're never wrong. Okay, so why is this person is spying? Okay, this person is spying because they're really at the root of everything. This is Archangel Raphael. This is why. And the root of this is why they're spying is because really they want to heal. See, this time when the tower came down, this person, it was so abrupt and so quick. You was, one day you was in their life, the next day you was gone. You stopped talking to them, you blocked them, you no longer wanted them in your life. So, this, when you did that, this person was lost. This person is in a deep depression, can't move forward, stuck, stagnant in their own mess. Because when spirit brought this tower, spirit did it in such a way that this person had no choice. They had no energy. They're low vibrational on their own. They were feeding off of your energy. So when it happened abruptly, they had nothing. And spirit did it that way to wake this person up. This person is deep down in a depression. They can't move forward. They're stuck, and they just can't, they can't handle this. They're fighting. They are desperate. This person is desperate to get back to your energy, to get back with you, because they are lost. They are literally lost in their thoughts, lost in anxiety, pain, suffering, because they have all this stuff that they got that they don't want to deal with, that they keep running from because they don't want to heal. And they don't want to face themselves. They don't want to face their ego. And they have too much pride. They don't want to face this. So, they want to heal. This person wants to heal. That's the root of it. But that's not what they would say. But this is why they're spying. Because when they look at you, and they see transformation. They see hope. They see faith. They see light. Because that's what a light worker is. We already said an empath is a light worker. That's what light workers do. They heal. So if you just look at them, or if you're around them, it's just naturally healing for you. It's a empath, a light worker is a natural healer. They don't have to put their hands on you. They don't have to be around, you. Empath that's really high vibrational, you can look at a picture and get, and it'll radiate through the picture. So this person knows that. This is whoever this is a high level light worker, empath. This person is really high. Look at this tree of life right here. This is the tree of life. This person have grown, leveled up, high vibrational. This person has seen that and want it back desperately. This person is willing to do anything to get this person back, just to get back to this energy. Okay, remember, the empath, they will say and do anything to get this back, when really they'll pull you back into it, into this connection, just to siphon your energy and drain you dry. Then the more they drain you, then you find yourself stuck back in the past, stuck back in a dead-end situation, stuck, stagnant when you were healed, but they pulled you back in some mess because they sucking you dry. The more energy they suck, then you have to transmute their energy and constantly keep transmuting their energy for you to be able to remain high vibrational so you can move forward. That's not fair. This person need to stand on their own and do their own work. Not you. Not transmuting their energy. That's good to go for a little while, but after a while, you can't keep doing that. This person has to level up on their own, do their own healing and work. But they're looking at you. This is what this is about. This is why they're spying, because they're looking at you. You're growing. You're leveling up. You're high vibrational. And this person wants to come in on that. Suck you dry. Get in on you. Manipulate you. They want their place back in your life. But you have grown from that. You're no longer that person anymore to enable them and to allow them to make a fool out of you. You're no longer this person anymore. You guard your energy. You learn from this person what not to do. But this person think you the same person, but you're not. That's why they spying. They want you back. They want that energy back. They want to manipulate you. Okay. All right. So what do they want to say? I love you. I know you don't believe it. I know the way things ended between us was difficult. It's very difficult for me. When I think about it and I see it, it's very difficult. But I want to change. I'm trying to change. I want to come back into your life. I want us to be back together. I miss you so much. I see you have changed so much. I really don't know how I can get back to you. You've changed so much. You have changed so much. But you are so beautiful. I'm loving the new you, but I want to know, how could I fit in with that new you? How could I fit in with you? How could I be in connection with you? I want to learn how to heal. I want to heal. I want to learn how to be a better version of myself. I just don't know how. And true. I have a lot of pride. I have a lot of ego. And true, I did manipulate you and I did use you. But I've learned that I want to be better. I want a chance to make it up to you. I want a chance to be a better version of myself. And I don't know what all that entails. I don't know what it'd be like. I don't know what I need to do. But I do want to try, because I love you just that much. I really do love you. That's what they want to say. Some of you guys, that's sincere. Some of you guys, that's a narcissist trying to manipulate you. You need to know the difference. Use your discernment, okay? All right, we got, no matter what, this person gonna come back to you no matter what. If you take them back or not, they don't know. I love you to the moon and back. Somebody loves you. It's, I love you again. Wow, I love you. This person imagines. They have so many dreams and imaginations about you. They think they can get you back. Okay? Grace. They want your forgiveness. They want your grace. They have so much faith in this relationship. They have so much faith in you. They want, here's the lock. They want to unlock your heart. Your heart is locked towards them. They want to give you flowers. They want to transform. They want to try to transform and renew themselves. They said, just trust them. They want you to trust them. Here's the tree of life. Growth, spiritual growth, leveling up. Somebody wants to level up. Somebody has leveled up. Okay. Here's faith. There's faith again. So this faith is significant here. Namaste. Somebody wants you to have faith. Here's wealth. We got grapes. So wealth and abundance. Somebody see you as their light. You are the light of their life. Okay. We have R. We have N. We have F. We have H. We have L. We have Q. We have F. We have I. We have M. We have O. We have M. Mom. Somebody's mom. Something dealing with a mom. We have T, we have H, we have Q. Okay. All right. So your messages are, what are you doing? I want to know. So this person, this narcissist or this person or your person, either or, because your person, just because I said this is a narcissist. Somebody could not be a narcissist, but this could just be your person that's acting like this. So you know if your person is a narcissist or not. But somebody wants to know what you're doing, and that's why they're spying on you. They want to know everything about you, what you're doing right now. They have no access to you, so they're spying and stalking you to find everything out. Are you seeing anyone? What you're doing? What if they could find out your thoughts? They want to know it. Okay. Why can't things go back the way they were before between us? See, this person wants to go back into the past because at the past time in the past, they was manipulating you and you couldn't see. So they had they were in control. So now they don't have any control, no access to you. And this person is having a hard time with that because they're lost without, they have no control. So this is hard for them. So this person wants to go back to the way it was. Okay, so here, Capricorn, a Capricorn man, masculine energy. It's maybe Capricorn. You are with another Capricorn. If you are, this is a message. You are the love of my life. There is no other that can compare to you. My soul is on fire for you. I want you so bad. So this is a Capricorn that's in love with another Capricorn, masculine energy. All right. So we got choose love. Okay. You always have a choice. Make yours with love. How about choose you? Self-love. How about that? Because when you're dealing with the tower and you're dealing with the narcissist, you've got to pour that love back into yourself. You have to heal. And what I'm getting here is a lot of you have healed, or you're on the road of healing. With this card here, you're healing and you're on the road of healing, because that's why this empath is so determined to get back to you, because you're high vibrational and you have been healing and they want that energy. But what I'm saying to you, choose you. It's time to choose love, but choose the love that's inside of you. Because at this time, if you choose wrong, you're going to have to go back through the healing process again. So take the time to choose you, choose love, choose self-love. Make sure that your mind is right, your heart is right, your soul is right. And even your body, make sure you're taking care of your body. That's part of me. I'm getting ready to start taking care of my body and working out and doing things like that to strengthen my body, you know. And so make sure that you do that. Choose you. Okay, choose love, choose you, self-love. That's how I'm gonna end that. Okay, all right, Capricorn, that has been your reading. I hope it resonated. If it did, leave me a comment. Let me leave you if you want to leave a story, I will read it. I read all comments. Thumb up if you like, thumb down if you didn't. Share. Don't keep it to yourself. If I'm vibing with you and you vibing with me, subscribe. Comment, guys. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, social media. Go to the description box. Guys, COVID is rising. I need you to take care of yourself. Take care of your family. Wash your hands. Put on your mask. Social distance. Indeed, Black Lives Matter. Indeed, your life matters. I'm sending you love. I'm sending you healing. And Trinity is